This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the properties of special parallelograms. Specifically, that will be the rhombus, the rectangle, and the square. So let's start with a rhombus. The formal definition for a rhombus is that it's a parallelogram with two adjacent sides congruent. We also have two properties for a rhombus. All sides are congruent, and the diagonals are perpendicular. So let's start with that definition. A parallelogram with two adjacent sides congruent. Here's what that means. If I've got parallelogram ABCD, then two of the adjacent sides, let's say side AB and side AD, will be congruent. They'll be the same length. Now, we also know that in any parallelogram, the opposite sides are congruent. So that would mean that since this is a parallelogram, as well as a specific type, a rhombus, side AB is congruent with side CD, and side AD is congruent with its opposite side, side BC. So that means all of the sides are congruent. Very often when people talk about a rhombus, rather than use the formal definition, they just say it's a parallelogram with four equal sides. And that's what we've got here. The second property that a rhombus has that isn't true of all parallelograms is that the diagonals are perpendicular. So let's look at that. I'll draw in the two diagonals. So I've got BD and line AC. And at the place where they intersect, I'll call that point E. The second property says that these two diagonals are perpendicular to each other, which would mean they form four right angles where they intersect. Let's check that. If I look at triangle ABE and triangle CBE, I can show that those are congruent triangles. Side AB is congruent with side BC. They both share side BE. And side AE is congruent with side EC because AC, that whole line, is a diagonal. And for any parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. So if AC has been bisected, that means that AE is congruent with EC. So now I've got two congruent triangles. The angle that I've got here at E, the angles that I've got at E, are corresponding angles for those two triangles, so they must be the same. But they're supplementary angles. So if I've got two equal supplementary angles, they must be 90 degrees each, so that they can add up to 180 degrees. In the same way, I could take the other two angles that are formed at that intersection and show that they're also 90 degree or right angles. So what that means is that the diagonals are perpendicular. Where they bisect, they form right angles. Okay, so those are basically the qualities that a rhombus has that aren't necessarily true of all parallelograms. All the sides are congruent and the diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Let's go on to the rectangle. So our definition of a rectangle is that it's a parallelogram with a right angle. And then we have two properties. All the angles are right angles, and the diagonals are congruent. So the definition, once again, says that it's a parallelogram with a right angle. So if I take this rectangle that I have, A, B, C, D, and I label one of the angles as a right angle, I can very easily show that all of the angles are right angles. I know that in a parallelogram, the consecutive angles are supplementary. Well, if I have two angles like A and B, and they're supplementary, and one angle is 90 degrees, then the other one must be 90 degrees, so that they can add up those two 90 degree angles to equal 180 degrees. And then I can go around the rest of the rectangle and mark all four of the angles as being right angles. So the property, all the angles are right angles is going to be true of any rectangle. And a lot of times when people talk about rectangles, they can say it's a parallelogram with four right angles. The second property says that the diagonals are congruent. Let's draw the diagonals in. So I'll draw in line BD and line AC. And I want to show that those two diagonals are the same length, that they're congruent. So let's look at two triangles that they form. I've got triangle BAD and triangle CDA. If I can show that those two triangles are congruent, then I can show that those long sides for each triangle, BD and CA, are congruent. Okay, well, we know that the opposite sides of any rectangle, of any parallelogram, are congruent. So BA must be congruent with CD. We know that angle A is a right angle, and angle D is a right angle. So we've got two sides that are congruent, two angles that are congruent, and both of the triangles share side AD. So we've got side angle side congruency. That's going to mean that triangle BAD is congruent with triangle CDA, and that AC must be congruent with BD. So that would be your proof that the diagonals are congruent. Okay, so once again, for a rectangle, the two specific properties they have that are not true of all parallelograms is that all the angles are right angles and the diagonals are congruent. And the last one we have is a square. So a square is a rectangle with two adjacent sides congruent. And the properties for it say that all angles are right angles, all sides are congruent, and the diagonals are perpendicular. Okay, so if all the angles are right angles, well, that makes sense because a square is a rectangle. And in a rectangle, all the angles are right angles. So a square is just a special form of a rectangle. All sides are congruent. Well, we know that two adjacent sides are congruent, which basically is the definition we're going to have for a rhombus. So a square is also a special kind of a rhombus, which means all four sides are congruent. And the diagonals are perpendicular. Once again, a square is a rectangle. And since a rectangle has diagonals that are perpendicular, the diagonals of a square will also be perpendicular. Okay? So those are the properties for the rhombus, the rectangle, and the square. Take care. I'll see you next time.